Welcome to Daily Neighborhood Ride. We are out here at Theo on the Ohm Duro. Just put a lone dropper post on this thing. Takes some getting used to riding this bike though. This bike is a 27 and a half inch wheel, 3 inches wide, and it's a fully rigid bike. Chrome Ollie frame and fork. It's a pretty heavy beast. I think it's somewhere just under 40 pounds, so it's not light, but it's pretty fun. One thing with fully rigid is you can stand up and pedal. Which is nice. I think some of the newer bikes full suspension are a lot easier to stand and pedal than my full suspension. Like my bike, it climbs well if you're seated in the saddle, but when you stand up and try to climb, you get a lot of bob out of the shock. This is kind of like a cross between an old clunker bike, BMX bike, and new school with the disc brakes and 27 and a half by 3 tire. That's pretty new school. And dropper post, internal cable routing. Dropper, but everything else about it, geometry, weight, is pretty old school. Oh, it takes some work for sure. Huffing and puffing. We just started riding. I don't ride this bike too much. This kind of beats my old body up, being fully rigid. Remember what I'm on. Ride it a little bit differently. Okay, we're on a to and fro trail on the Area 36 trails. Ooh, nose high. We gotta get used to this. Tried popping too much off of that little jump. A little scary. Definitely feeling the weight of this bike. This bike probably comes in about 9 pounds heavier than my full suspension. That's not very forgiving. And that's fully rigid. Ouch! We cleared that ridge, but ooh, that hurt a little bit. We're bouncing all over the place. So much easier to climb when you can raise the seat post up really high. I always just tried to run the seat in like a kind of a medium position where it was, you know, okay for climbing. Felt good to still jump and stuff, but now I'm trying to get used to this 200 millimeters of drop, which is pretty cool. I'm still learning when and where to drop it, so that will take some time, I think. Like I said earlier, one thing at least nice about this bike is you can stand up and climb and there's no suspension bob, because there's no suspension. I can definitely tell it's a lot more work throwing this thing around though, and then bouncing around on a couple basketballs basically. There should be a gap right there, cut that corner. That'll be interesting to see that small double farther down this trail, if I can even jump it on this. I just saw someone jump this double for the first time I've ever seen anyone else jump it. But I didn't film him. But not quite sure I can do it on this bike. Let's find out. I'm a little nervous. Oh yeah, we got it. I just need a little more speed. No problem. All right, we got the other camera going slow-mo. This thing is a beast. Oh, I'm not sure if I can be able to clear this or not. No, it was high, but we cleared it. Oh, God, I was double. I'll have to try again. Let's try it again. That was scary. Got the second one. See if we can clear this thing. Yeah! Ooh! Trying not to really paddle. Ooh, a little nose high! Ooh, pedal strike. A lot more pedal strikes on this bike. And my mountain bike. Oh, I tell you, my back feels it a lot more. I'm fully rigid. sketchy. This bike is just such a tank. It's really fun though. Man, they probably need to start going to the gym. My legs are sore, my arms are sore. Whoa! All right, the home duro at Theo. I was heading back home down the tracks. Thanks for checking out Daily Neighborhood Ride. Ride on.